Hi guys, we've come to Bars Court, which from the looks of it was an old Farmore Manor house. There's not actually very much here, to be honest, but there is a playground, so the grandchildren are playing, and we can have a little look around. As far as I can make out, this is actually all that's left. What you can see as I turn around here. So we've got a couple of windows and a few bits of wall. And that's it. I will sort of walk around a bit so we can see a bit more, but there's still part of the moat here. One of those slit windows, supposedly for protecting yourself from enemies, your bows and arrows or whatever. And through there I think is actually part of the moat. But I'll do a bit of a walk round and just see the top of the playground over there. Actually testing out the shotgun microphone with the dead kitten on it, see if that cures a bit of the wind noise. There's not much wind. The moat does actually run around the outside here. I'll walk over there in a minute and show you. That's one side. And there's a corner there, and it goes all the way along that side. Corner there, comes back along that side. Let's zoom out a bit, I suppose. Up to where we were just now. I'll walk around this way. Yes. Nothing much there to look at all, is there? Well, that's a bit too overgrown. I'm not going to make the effort to go around there. I was going to say that was a seagull in the middle there, but we're supposed to be a bit more specific than that. So I'll look it up when we get back. Sorry, a bit jerky, this is all handheld, no tripod. Right, so I believe the moat is behind this bush. We'll see if we can get through anywhere to have a look at it. That was a blackbird just there. Pigeon flying away. Wood pigeon. Again, that's a bit heavily overgrown. We can peek through the gap though. That's duckweed on top of the moat. So the moat turns a corner here. I'll probably speed some of this up so you don't have to wait for me walking, or maybe edit it a bit. Another bit of access down to the moat. Again, completely covered in duckweed. Oh, there's actually a goose. Where's it gone? I can't focus on it because it's behind the twigs. Can I get a different angle? No, not going to focus on that. Okay, moving on. Looks like you can walk on it, doesn't it? That wouldn't be a good idea. I can hear a duck. We'll walk around a bit further. Got some pop bottles in there. All a bit overgrown because it's that time of year, I guess. Oh, look, a dog poo bag. I wonder if that one's empty. Looks like it is, looks like it's just blown there. Some genuine dog poo. I can hear the ducks. Well, they are there. Don't think we'll be able to see them. There's access across the moat there. A duck or two. The noisy one. Oh, they're supposed to eat all this duckweed, aren't they? Not doing a very good job. Alright, I'll carry on around. Right, two more beverage containers, pop bottles. That's the next stretch. I think we can walk along that side. There's a little bit of water flowing. Not much. It looks a bit scummy. It's obviously not enough water flowing. In fact, that's just plain mud there. A trickle of water through the middle of it. This is all in the middle of a housing estate. Which probably accounts for all the pop bottles and that. Oh, there we are. Got a mother and some babies. Oh, and a moorhen. On these brambles. It's not very deep at all down to the mud. Don't think I could even put my boat in there. I have done in the past. I'm not entirely sure what that is. Whether that's a female moorhen or something. I'll have to look that up. Okay, moving on. So there's the housing estate right around the edges of this site. See the playground on the other side. Well, that's not deep water. But it might be on the other side. chased by a family with children. Somebody's football. Not sure what that one is. Wind blowing across at the moment. Find out if my dead kitten works. Just see if I can focus on that gull. Rest on the bench here. That's better. Not much better though. Sorry about the jerky movements. Quite windy now. Was that something under the water that bird just pecked? I thought it was just a piece of wood or something, but it's gone. I'll walk around and see if I can see that again. Well, I wonder if there's a big carp in there.
That's
have an idea those gulls might be terns. It's just come to me. We'll see. Some people throwing bread to them at the moment, that's why all the birds have, all the ducks are coming round. But those terns are trying to grab it. Yeah. I'll call them terns for now, I've no idea. These are wild ones, so you don't take them from the wild to be pets.
Moorhen.
Yeah, well done, they are moorhens, because they've got red beaks. Or do you think that one is just over there?
A lady moorhen.
Well, yeah, it might be a lady there's one, enough. Not a male, not a man one.
There's the other chicks coming down.
They're a bit older than these ones, aren't they? These,
yeah.
These
are... those are the things I saw coming
down. Yeah, there's one here.
There's another little one. Those chicks are big.
Right? Yeah, they look like they're a few weeks older, don't they?
Yeah. Look, she's got five.
Where's she gonna go now? Keep still, so we don't want to scare her.
Oh, well, they've gone underneath. Think you're going to feed them.
No, it's a duck!
Don't trust people.
I think that's a juvenile moorhen, isn't it?
I can take it out of the Wi-Fi, and if I can take it out of the phone, it's not.